How are you? I bet you thought I wasn't going to come up tonight. But that is part of the new thing, too. You see, before I used to try to answer all of you individually, and now I get to do one blank answer. But I have my computer in front of me, and I'm going to answer some of you as I go along. So I love this video thing, so much different. Anyway, I've kind of changed where I'm sitting today, so allow me to get comfortable. Alright, so here we go. Let's see, the first one, Miss Tello. I love you too. And Roger, thank you for the compliment. You love the theme of the blog. Thank you so much. And Rob, here's my answer for you, because I thought your response was interesting. Knowing what speaks to you is a whole lot easier than getting there. True. But the thing that most people forget is that nothing happens overnight. Nothing. We grow into everything. Every day is a new day. It may be, it's about, so you find something that speaks to you. Let's say that. You find something that speaks to you, but you know that saying, you got to be willing to do something you love and then you're never working. Sometimes we don't make money at our passions, but they make us happy regardless. And it makes it a lot easier to do that other stuff that we could care less about. So it is easier said than done, but everything's not going to be easy. Some things are, some things aren't. But it's just about what speaks to you. Because now we're dealing with what makes you happy. And if you can make money at what makes you happy, that's gravy. But if you can just find something that brings joy, it just brings so much more to your life. And I think that's kind of where I was touching upon, but we'll keep moving along. All right, let's see. Beckham, I think it is. What did you say? Love it, great job. Oh, great idea to speak via video. Okay. You love to get a better job, move out of wherever you are, and get married or have a commitment series. Okay. If that's what you want, get a plan. That's for all of it at the end of the day to address some of those questions. Get a plan. If that's what you want, now we need a plan. You get a better job, that means getting your resume together, updating it, making sure it's the best resume you can sit out there, and then you submit it to the places that you think are going to be interested. That's just how I always thought it worked. But, you know, I mean, that's kind of what it is. It's making a plan and putting it to action. If that's what you want. You want to get married or a commitment ceremony, amen, and I wish you that. So then we got to find that person that's the right person to be that person for us. That was very complicated, but you know what I meant. Okay, who do we have? Okay, Ephraim, you agree with Rob. Well, you know, everything can't be easy. That's all I got to say. I'm going to say it again. Some things take time, but I got a really sweet email from a very dear MySpace friend of mine, Toya. And she said that she can see how different her life is in a year. And I think sometimes we have to do that, because sometimes when we're in it, in the thick of it, we don't think we're making any progress. But really, we are, a lot more so than we think. So you kind of got to just have faith and look at your life a year ago. How much closer are you now to where you wanted to be than you were a year ago? And that's a good gauge, at least I think so. Shelley, my very dear friend, I love you too, and I'm so grateful that I could help you. It was my pleasure and my honor to be your friend and to be of any help that I was. So thank you, and I love you too. And let's see. Angela, I gotta be honest with you. I'm having a little trouble here. But basically you're saying, who do you give up? You're asking about relationships. Thinking about relationships are tricky because you're dealing with another soul. You're dealing with another person's free will. So, again, at least for me, I'm really clear about who I am. I'm really clear about the things that are important to me in my life. I think that's the key thing. And looking for more like-minded people to be around, to surround yourself by. It's like that saying, be around people that are doing what you want to do. So I have people around me that are a lot like me, and the men in my life are like me, you know, which is rare, but like me. So I look for like-minded people, and I think that's where I think most relationships fall, that they're really not alike. They just were two people that kind of thought it was hip at the time. And I've written blogs about that, how you fall in. You start dating somebody, you go on 3 or 4 dates, and you're not alone. Now they're fun to go to movies with. Okay, yeah, that's all great. But if you're not sharing that thing, that something, it's a wrap. So, just for me. I don't know if I really answered your question, but I hope so. Gabriel, I'm sure I'll talk to you soon. There were a couple things that were just really interesting when I read them, so, but for those of you that paid me a compliment, thank you ever so. I appreciate it. I'm not really sure if I answered any of the questions as accurately as you might have liked, but I'm going to try to do that from now on, to just answer the questions, so whatever the theme is, we'll be able to keep that theme going for the week. So if you have questions, you have to send them in, and then I'll respond. But basically, first of all, we're trying to find out what speaks to you. If you can find that first, everything else kind of falls into place. It isn't always about making money at what speaks to you. It's about finding the thing that gives you peace and that gives you joy, the thing that makes you happy. For me, I can't live without music. I need music like other people need food and water. It isn't that I have to sing it. I gotta hear it. I have to have it playing all day. I gotta have music. So for me, that's my thing. It's the thing that makes me happy. And when I'm really sad or down, I turn on music, I feel so much better. For everybody, it's different. I'm a walker. I do yoga. Those things work for me. I love doing those things. You don't have to pay me to do those things. Now, on the other hand, there are things that I've done in my life that I make money at that I do enjoy. They don't necessarily speak to me, but they're things that I enjoy. So it's about finding that peace in your life. But if we were going to go to things that you make money at, you still have to, it's still good to find something that you enjoy. Just so you're not miserable. But if you're doing something, you're making a good living, you're not jumping off the ceiling about it, but you don't hate it, I say, just find that other thing that's going to make you happy. You know, unless you just want to change your life. If you're ready for that kind of a change, by all means. I've made those changes too, so you should do the thing that speaks to you. Again, and as far as relationships are concerned, the person that speaks to you. It's not always about how somebody looks. I know some gorgeous men. I know some rich men. But it's the one that speaks to me. I've dated fat, bald, short, thin, whatever. But it was what spoke to me. I connected with their soul. I didn't connect with their wallet or their height or their looks. I connected to their heart, and I adored them, and probably why to this day, even if we aren't still together, I'm friends with everybody I've ever dated from, like, childhood, because I really liked them, and they really liked me, so maybe the relationship ran its course, or for whatever reason we were separated, but we're still friends. And my friends are the same way. I connect with souls. I'm not everybody's friend. I mean, I'm people's acquaintance, but I don't invite everyone into my life. into my inner circle. That's a very special place to be. I think that's the dangerous thing that we do. So I'm not sure if I answered this all, but I think so. It's just about connecting. It's about finding what speaks to you, be it your job, your hobby, or the people around you, your mate. It's about finding what speaks to you, what makes your heart sing, just that thing that you can't live without. So that would be the question for the night. What is it you can't live without? I'll see you soon. Wishing you an abundance of love, happiness, and prosperity. Have a good Thursday. Bye.